This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, today we'll see this list of topics in introduction topics to internal Power BI side. So first one is, what is a Power BI? So Power BI is a, people will say like a visualization tool, or people generally think like it's a kind of a data connecting tool. So that's, both are actually right. So Power BI is a software, and this software will help us to work with the data and connectivity, and develop the visualization with the reporting format. Okay, so we'll go one by one process. So what is a Power BI? So first, as a basic of understanding, Power BI is a software. Okay, so this software, actually this software is developed by Microsoft. So generally, we generally aware, so we'll very familiar with the Microsoft company, because of we'll use Microsoft Windows, we'll use Microsoft MS Office. So we have Skype. They, like, Microsoft company has a different kind of products in the market, and it's in a top MNC, like a top reputed company in the world. Okay, so 90% IT is depending on Microsoft product. So this is the way Microsoft has one good product called Power BI, is a work with data visualization and a reporting process. So what is the use of this process? So Power BI is a data visualization software. Okay, and Power BI is also generally called like data reporting. So this is about Power BI thing. So how we can see it, Power BI side. So after installing, we can see this Power BI page. So we'll say this is kind of a report page area, like a home kind of page process. Here we can see visualizations option. So we can connect the data, different datas, and we can see a visualizations here. So we have a lot of visualizations inbuilt in Power BI. So that is the reason we can call a Power BI as a visualization software. Next, how the reporting things will be work into a Power BI side. So now we'll just classify Power and BI. So Power and BI differentiation, power nothing but a energy or to work a dynamic process, and BI nothing but a business intelligence. Okay, so power is a general word to work with a quicker or faster kind of process. So, and BI comes under a business intelligence. So business intelligence, what is mean by business intelligence? Business intelligence is nothing but how our company is performing, like how our company is working into the market process. Okay, the simple word is company or industry working process. So the best example for this is, so generally if you look at a newspaper or any news in a daily, you will see some graphs how the trends, like a financial trend is going into the market, how the share value got achieved or suddenly it got dropped. It will give a news or headlines or any news presentation or newspaper level, business paper level, we'll see some charts, line charts or bar charts. Or if you see a cricket score, sometimes it will give some charts how the score was highlighted or how the overs are completed. Okay, so these are all things are done by a reporting process that you can call business intelligence. How the business process, how the working process is going into the market, how we can understand by the company performance into the current situation, or what about the next situation coming into the market. So based on that, people will go and invest the money. Okay, suppose today Samsung company was performing well, so then people will go and buy the Samsung company products. Okay, because of Samsung company is performing a good market into the outside. So they are introducing a good products to reach a people. Suppose in the same time, suppose a Dell company is not performing well, then Dell laptops people will not buy. People will go and buy more HP laptops. So like the same way, how the company, like how the industry side, how the working companies are performing, then they have to see a budgets, how they're maintaining, how they're financially going strong, how the investments are coming. So those are all subjectively we can understand by BI, business intelligence. So business intelligence is a more, BI is more understanding to company data with information. Generally, if you see a Paytm, when they started in a business, they very have less users, like 100 members, 150 members. Now we have crores of people into the Paytm process. How they are giving a good service to the market to reach people requirements. So in that way, the how the BIs tell us to in a company, so they are having this kind of requirements we are achieving, we are into the top market, into the company market side. So they will give a more interactive process to the users to reach their business process. So how the companies will perform based on their working process, if the company is reaching into the market, then people can interact. If the performing, if the company performing is poor, then people will not reach out to the their products and their usage. So BI, so completely related to all kind of market performance in the world. Data is a, so in these companies everything is required data. Okay, I have said a Paytm. Paytm has a 10 customers or 20 customers. So they'll, when you generally install their product or something, they'll ask you your details and all, right? You will fill your name and details or something. That's what they're collecting. That means they're taking the data to maintain. We are strong into the maintaining the customer requirements. So here data, nothing but our details, like our name, our phone number, our email ID, whatever it is, everything is a data. So data is nothing but what? A collection of information to maintain to for a company saving and updates process. So data will comes under it. Data is a collecting of information to give as storage and maintain for updates. So after what we'll do? So after we'll use a BI process, we use a BI process to develop reports. Okay, then next day Paytm company or any company will come to the market. I have 1 crore of amount I received from 10,000 customers for this month. Okay, so this financial I achieved from these customers, so thank you or something. Next people will invest more money, they will get more money into the future days. So how the companies are going perform better, investments or you know subscribers or consumers, everything is related to a company growing working process. Next, the continuous process we'll see on a BI side has a two types of process. So BI business intelligence, here we have two types of process. What is the two types of process? So first one is traditional process. Second one is a self-service process. Okay, what the differences are both? So traditional and self-service, the one word difference is only the companies with their products and with their usage. Okay, so BI is a subjective part, and like a software of data reporting tools is work on two types, traditional or self-service. So question coming to the Power BI is comes under which part, as a traditional or self-service? Power BI comes under a self-service because of no coding, no process. Traditional has coding and further process. To understand this process, you know, suppose we have data. Okay, we can get data from the.
Hi.
Yes, sorry.
So traditional means coding means it will come as MS BI, right?
Yes, MS BI is an older technology, outdated technology. Power BI is a new technology.
Okay,
yeah, we'll go into that part. Just wait for a moment, I'll explain detail. So here, so data has to, as a BI process in a older to now, we have two types of process. So data is an information perspective, has every company. Okay, we'll maintain for a storage and reuse purpose. So here BI process will consider data with that BI process has two types. So the BI with the process has, we can say, one is a traditional, second one is a self-service. Okay, so the traditional, the simple and standard words are old technologies simply, and self-service completely a new introduced technology process. Okay, here, so traditional process, I can say a Cognos, OBI, SAS and MSBI, those all comes under a traditional process. And self-service model has Power BI into the market to achieve the process. And here completely no coding process. So what is the no coding process? Coding people will say, what is the coding? It is Java code or some any Python code or something. So code nothing but what are the data purpose they are called to use, they have to transform into their standards. Suppose data is like a English, sir, data communicative like a SQL. So SQL is like a English. Suppose think like a SQL is like a English. The English word, if I say to some other person to communicate, so coming to Cognos, expert like a Chinese. Okay, so I have to make a mediator between to communicate English transform to Cognos. Cognos as a Chinese. So here we should transform or convert a SQL to or some other language to Cognos standard. So coming to OBI, OBI think like a Japanese. So we have to change the standard to convert as a Japanese. So these standards follow based on company coding style. So Cognos is from some company, like Cognos is from Oracle. So they have to, so Cognos is from, you know, IBM. So they have to follow for their standards. OBI is from Oracle, they have to follow their standards. Okay, like that. Next, coming to Power BI, so nothing, no coding, no transformation, no education, simply connecting the data and work with report process. Okay, the coding is a simple word, nothing but SQL to functional code. Functional code will treat like a Chinese or Japanese or something languages. Okay, so this is done by based on the company, not a developer. They have to follow their standards. Coming to Power BI, no coding. No coding process, nothing but no coding means zero coding process. Okay, so here both data communicative standards we can use SQL for a connectivity purpose, but as a self-service model is completely zero coding. Okay, as a Power BI side it will connect any kind of data. But coming to Cognos and OBI MS BI standard, they have to use only dedicated to SQL servers. They have to use their own dedicated to Oracle databases like that. But coming to self-service, we can use like any kind of services into the data side. So now coming to this part. So what is the traditional process most in, you know, important into self-service, traditional and self-service differences? So we have to here. So get the data. Okay, the point is we have to get the data with writing of code. Okay, next, data will get from only one data base. Here reporting tool has coding process. Because if you use Cognos, it has own coding process. If you use OBI, it has own coding process. Like reporting tool has a coding, and also data also need a coding process. So now we have to write the SQL and convert into functional code, writing the point based on tool. Which tool you are using, based on those tool you have to convert it. So what are the tools are available today? We have Power BI, and what are the past days? So we have Cognos on the time, OBI, MSBI, SAS. These are all old, outdated tools. Why it got outdated? Only the reason of coding. So nowadays, industry and people are not ready to write a code and execute and a dependency process. So we need a self process to work automatically. So here always face the issues. What kind of issues? With coding compatibilities. Okay, we'll always face issue with coding to execute for report development. Okay, we have to complete the work. If the coding is giving the issue, we cannot complete the work in on time. Then client will not give a further extension or further development to the company. So it will affect to the complete revenue process. Okay, so to do achieve in this process, then later, you know, after 2015 time, so 2016-17 time, Microsoft realized and released a Power BI into the market to achieve into the self-service product. So now coming to the self-service. So what is the benefit here? So here we can see a completely, we can get the data, without using any code. Data will get from different data sources, and Power BI can connect any databases, any data sources. So this is advanced. Advanced reporting tool process. Here, no coding and manual works. Tool is fully automatic process. To develop and maintain the data process. Tool name is Power BI. Software, Power BI software or a tool, whatever it is, software from Microsoft. Because of Microsoft standards only, doesn't have any coding to perform into the market, because of Microsoft is a very friendly, open, you know, interactive standards, always give like a user friendly to work with any softwares. So this is the way Microsoft is involved to work with any kind of process to anywhere. So issues side, we don't see any issues because it will work automatically, right? So not giving any issues from data side due to dynamic process with zero coding technology. Okay, this is the process. Okay, now we can see Power BI side. So go to Power BI. Here we can see data option. So get data option. So finally we have to work with the data to connect. See, I'm showing you some Excel file. So this is the data. Okay, this is the realistic data to understand data with a proper details. So which customer what ordered and which date he ordered, which date got it shipped, and what is the customer name, what is the customer place and location, how much the sales was performed, any discount we given, or any how much quantity he purchased. So everything is a detailed data we have. So same data I'm going to connect into the Power BI side. So coming to Power BI side, here we can see get data option. So here we can see get data option. We have to connect the data into Power BI report process. Go to get data option. Here you can see a more option. Click on more option. When we select a more option, the more option will give a detail of different kind of data connectivities are available. So Power BI can connect any kind of data. Okay, if you look at my text, here we can see only dedicated data in a traditional process. But here we can see different data sources we can connect. This is completely advanced reporting tool process. So this way we can see data connectivities and work with Power BI part. Okay, so just a moment, sorry for disturbing. Hi all, just for your reminding, so please connect to Swapna to provide your details to get the next classes updates. So please reach out to her. So this is the contact detail. So please send your details to Swapna. Don't forget, please send immediately. And this process we can see continuously and a connectivity of process. Suppose if I want to connect an Excel file, I can click that Excel file. So I can browse my Excel file to connect with my data. So I'm connecting my orders data to browse from my side. So when I'm selecting my data, so now Power BI is automatically connect to get the data process to work for a loading time. So coming to Excel side, I have a one sheet and another sheets are blanks. So the same representation Power BI is trying to show me. So I have orders table data, select that order tables. We can see the data for that. Okay, once we confirm, then you can click to load option. And we have some transform data option. So this option we can see later, but also we can do some corrections into the data part also. But we can see after few days, we'll see transform data. Now you can click to load option. Once we selected a load option, automatically Power BI will generate a data. See the first day, understand the preview. So this preview is showing how the our Excel file is looking like. The same way it will trying to show into detail process. Each column and each row and with a detail information, everything is presenting. Once we selected a load option, then automatically Power BI will get the data to load with a, its own process to automatic to work. It's not asking a single code process to write and execute. Okay. Then you can see data fields area. You can see open orders. Here we can see the same things coming like a titles or a column names. Here we have customer name, category, city kind of process. So this is completely report area. When you look at the left hand side, we have report area and also we have data area. We have relation area or model area. So we have report area. The report area we can see to develop the reports. If you want to look at the data, go to data area, detail data area. Here we can see data with proper information. How the Excel presentation is looking here. The same Excel kind of look and feel here you can see into the inbuilt. Okay. So most of field is like a Excel process because of Microsoft product only, right? So few look and feel is coming under a same kind of process. Next, go to report area. So in a report area, we can see only column names like heading names. We can bring it here, these things into a this canvas area, this empty area. How? We'll see next to next steps. So the same way, the connect to the data part here, we can see shortcut levels also get the data process. Also you can go to get data option. So Power BI can connect a many kind of data process to work with any kind of process into the performance level. So coming to the Power BI side, how we can interact with the work and further steps, we can see one by one. So coming to Power BI side, so connectivity part. Power BI. As many data source connections. Power BI can connect any kind of data for report process. General people can say what kind of data. So example purpose. So Excel, Notepad, PDFs, and databases. You can see databases around like 40-50 databases, it will connect. Here, Power BI connect the data without writing any coding. After connecting the data, shows the preview window, preview window to see the data. See the data to load. Okay. So once we connect the data, it will ask you to preview to connect and load the process to into Power BI side. Once you selected a load option, then automatically Power BI will maintain. So this is repeative. If you connect any kind of data, it will repeat you. So today I connected a Excel file, right? Tomorrow I'll show you the database connectivity. So it will most like similar. So tomorrow I'll show you a database part. So Power BI also can connect. You see here, Power BI also can connect. Cloud databases also. What is a cloud database? So simple, and nowadays we have, you know, Azure database and, you know, AWS, Amazon databases and all, right? So those databases also it will connect based on your company and maintenance process. So Power BI maintain data security of data from reporting process. Here we can observe the data with detail information in Power BI software. Connecting the data, also it will give you a clear picture. What are the heading names it has, it will give a clear picture. Also go to data array, also it will give a clear picture to understand the data process. So this way we can interact, easy way to develop the report process. Next, coming to interfaces side. So how many types of interfaces we have into Power BI side? So when you look at the Power BI side, here we have three types of interfaces we have. Okay, we are into reporting area. Reporting area, we can connect the data, we can see visualization, we can build it. So example report I'll develop now. So I want to see a product wise sales. So go to your fields data. We have report data process. Select your data field, some products and sales I'm trying to select. So once I selected, I can see the some text information into the this report area. So in this report area canvas level, we can see detail level of text information as a table format. If I am not interested to see this format, here I have visualizations. Select the visualization. If you select this one, it will give a bar chart. Suppose if you select this one, it will give a pie chart. If you select this one, it will give a box, tree map box. So like that, what kind of visualization we are ready to select, then Power BI will give the visualization requirement for that. So this is can called reporting. Just a single button click, we can see a different visualization presentation. Okay, we can connect our data, we can bring your data into here, just select what are the data we required, then Power BI will give you different visualizations with different kind of formats. Next, I want to see a category wise sales. So select the category and select the sales. The small information I'm trying to represent is the pie chart. So this way I can show my data into a bar chart level of this detail information. Also I'll use a pie chart with a detail kind of presentation process. So it will give a mouse over, it will give a what is the detail level of information also there, it will go into the text process. So category is a technology, this much just sales, and this is a subcategory, this is a value for this tables and storage process. And also if you observe which is the highest process, like a sale we are getting, that'll give into the top. Which are giving a lesser value, it will give it a down. So this visualization standard formatting also Power BI I'll automatically maintain into the tool side development. So this is the report area. This interface of report will develop the reports one by one. It has a pages, like if you take another page, will develop continuously another pages to other requirements. Okay, so pages will continue like a kind of slide process. Then go to data. When you come into the data,
sorry to interrupt, so can we show it as a graphical?
Yes, we are into visualization area.
Yeah, here can we show this data in a graphical presentation?
This is the graphical presentation, right?
No, like this is apart from this bar chart and pie chart. If customer want to show this the data as in a graphic, graph wise,
you're asking a line chart wise, this one?
Yeah.
So see, Graphical means these are all graphic. Visualization, graphic, both are same names. Okay. You are here. We have to understand the name of the chart. This is can called line. This is can called bar. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. So these visualizations are inbuilted to work like selecting and apply. Then go to data part. So data part, as we understand last 10 minutes back, it will give a detailed picture what is the inside of the data process. Next, go to a model part. In this model part, if you are connecting a more data, okay, I am connected orders. If you want to connect a more data, here we can build our own data with the relationship process to make a reporting process. So this step we can see future, not today, because of it has a need more data process. As an initial beginning process, we have to understand how the reporting is going. Okay, so this way we have three interfaces for three kind of data works. One is a reporting process for developer reports, data area for to see the data, model area to or understand with a what kind of data connectivity we are doing. So these three interactions we'll see in a three different interfaces. So this is giving by tool, nothing but this is giving by software. So we are not giving any customization here. We cannot create any new, you know, interface here. We have to work with these default things only. So coming to the part, note part. So interfaces. So Power BI has three types of interfaces. Or people will say like windows also, three windows also we can say. So what is that? So first one is report, second one is data, third one is model. What is a report? So report nothing but develop the reports simply. Data nothing but see the data and analyze. Model connect and see other data. So these three interactions or these three interfaces we can see into the Power BI interfaces. So next, data analysis part, how we can do in a Power BI set. So generally, as a data analysis word, people will say, you know, so more interactive process we'll see into Power BI. Simply, like data analysis is most important in a reporting process. So when you look at a Power BI side, so this is a visualization I have developed. Someone has asked me like to develop in other visualization, like a line chart. I can go and quickly change into some other way. But here the thing is, we should understand the data first. Okay, how the value is going, we should understand. So to do that, here we have a table data also. You can see into the table data format. Not in a visualization, also we can do analysis into the table format also. This table format level, we can understand without giving any graphical, without giving any visualization to develop a report process. Okay. After understanding the numbers, then you can select which visualization we require to apply. Okay. Based on client suggestion or your idea, both mutual understanding, we can give and present to the user to understand a detailed process. So this is the one analysis part. Visualization give a clear picture as a single eye point contact. Now we'll go to data area. So here data area also has a very huge information, very detailed information. Okay, the same way you can see in Excel also, we can see a scroll bar. We can see how many rows are there. We can see everything is interacted here. Okay, the same way we can understand data with detail of interaction levels. So here a data analysis part in Power BI side. So Power BI report area give the visual picture. Visual report to report in better analysis. Okay. If you don't want any better analysis, go data area. We'll give the detail. Detail, data information. Detail, data information for all business values. Okay, if you are, what are the data you are giving, it will reach to some business area, right? So what is the business analysis or business requirement? Everything you look into the data side. Also, Power BI has table format view to see the data in member format. Okay, detail formatting also we can see into the data analysis part. So work with the report area is a completely develop of developing of working process. So working with report area, 100% report development. Who will develop the 100%? Developer. Who the developer? Power BI developer. So Power BI developer develop the reports in report area with the using of visualization and development process. So that is the weightage of report area. Report area only the important to see a output to develop. So report area as page, nothing but pages. So like a page 1 comma page 2 will come. See, go to report area. I have page 1. I selected a plus button. It will give a new page. In a new page also you can develop some more visualizations or some more graphical or some more reports based on requirement. Okay, suppose here I want to see date wise sales. So I'm selecting my date. It's a trend off line. It will give you what is a clear picture of daily sales is going. Okay, how the year wise sales are going. So this page will give a new interactive of graphical pictures. Next new page, it will give another continuously develop some more. So here I want to see, suppose a segment wise sales and profit, how is going. So I've selected this one. I'm going to see what is the segment wise sales are going. I can change the visualization also like this. Okay, the page will give a new interactivity, new interaction process to, you know, develop a new graphical pictures or new visualizations. Okay, so here pages are give a control to develop the reports with visual settings in Power BI. This is a regular. Next, creating a visualizations in Power BI. So when you look at here, so I can change a different kind of picture. Suppose I don't want to see in a line chart, I can go and see quickly select and, you know, select into some more like a area charts or some more like in a bar chart or some more like, you know, some circle chart. So I can select quickly. So this graphical or this visualizations option is inbuilt. So this is not developed by me. This is already developed by Microsoft giving to select option. Okay, creating a visualizations. So Power BI has inbuilt of visual charts. We can use and apply for our requirements. Okay, this is just giving by Microsoft. Next, applying filters into the dashboard. So after seeing these results, okay, can I apply some any filtering process to see any detail level of data process? Yes, it's also part of analysis process. To here we can see filters on this page and filters on all pages. So we have different kind of filter options, but as of now, as a instant process, I am using filters on this page. So selecting my region to give into the filters on this page option, I can select a central wise how the sales are going, as a east wise how is going. So when I am selecting the graphical representation is trying to change and giving a new update. See, when I selecting a west, it will automatically changing the values. When I selecting the south, it's changing. When I selecting east, it's changing the value. Central is changing. So how it will got impacting? When you are selecting some information, the respective information is getting from the data and give a new update. Okay. When you look at a central site, so but the central site chase values is 85. Suppose the same one, if I go to east side, the east side chase value is 96. Okay. Suppose the same way, if I go to south, the south wise, the chase values are very down, like 45. Okay. So it will performing how the product is performing to the market into based on different region and different business market. Okay. It will there a regular way. Okay. Maybe in Hyderabad, people will buy more Dell laptops. Maybe in a Bangalore area, people will buy more HP laptops. Okay. So maybe in a location or maybe a service level or maybe on a marketing perspective. So people will reach the products and buy the market from the market in a different situations. So the companies has to realize we have to give more offers or more benefits to the customers to reach and buy our products into the market side. So applying a filters, yes, we can do. Yes, we can apply. Use the filter option to apply into onto page or pages in Power BI. Okay. After it will work with after it will work with visual. It will affecting the visuals, right? It's changing visualization changes. After it will work with visual effects. Visual effects in Power BI reports. Okay. Next, set up the data relationships. So this process, setting up relationships process, yes, we can do, but right now I'm just saying a highlighting of summary line, but as a detailed practical connectivity part, we'll show in update upcoming classes. Yes, we can connect with data from different sources based on requirement. Okay, so this way we can connect. So coming to here, we have understand a report area and data area and relation area, model area. In a model area, we have orders information. We can see orders information as of now. In the future class, we can see some other connectivities also. Here we can see get data option. We can get some other data process to get information. In a continuous class, maybe tomorrow or day after tomorrow, we'll see continuous of connecting process. Okay, so just recalling everything. So going to the top. So what is a Power BI? So Power BI is a software is giving by Microsoft company to develop a report process purpose. It has a visualization options inbuilt there, and Power BI is a completely comes under a data reporting process. The data reporting is a easy word. The general word, the technical word is BI. So business intelligence, like a company working process. So what is the understanding process? We'll work with the data process center. Okay. What is the data? It's a collecting of information to storage and reuse purpose into the market. Next, Coming to the BI, so any types are available. Yes, we have two types, nothing but we classified those things to the technology side. We have old technologies like, you know, Cognos, OBI, and all. Now we have new technology like a Power BI. The simple difference is here we have coding, here we don't have any code. So traditional process completely work with the coding style. That is the reason is outdated. No one is using, and any industry is not ready to, you know, work with these old technologies. Now with the new technologies of Power BI, connect with any data like coming from Microsoft, it got updated with fully automatic functionalities. It's inbuilt process. What is the inbuilt process? It has inbuilt of connectivity of data. How it will connect? It will connect a different kind of data. What kind of data? It will connect a flat files, Excel, PDFs, and databases, Azure or cloud database, everything. Okay, is there any security issues? No issues. Power will maintain its own security process to maintain its own for your company, laptops, and company infrastructure itself. Next, how after installing Power BI, it will say. So after installing a Power BI, you can see the get data option to get the data process. Once you select the get data option, we'll bring our data to work with a data process. After loading, we can see three interfaces here, report, data, model. So coming to the three interfaces side, report, develop the reports, data to see the analysis purpose, and model area to connect with the other data process. So data analysis completely work with Power BI as a two areas level. One is report area, one is data area. So detail way, working with a report area, 100% completely development process. Developer has to work with report development. If it will give a page options. Suppose if you go to Excel, how it's Excel is giving sheet option. If you select a new sheet, the same way Power BI is also giving a page option. Okay, so each page we can develop different kind of visualizations, different kind of requirements. So after visualization completion, we'll see visualization process to change the chart. Any filtering process we can do? Yes, we can apply different kind of filters also we have. We'll see those items into upcoming classes. But as initial interacting, yes, we can interact with the filtering option to the Power BI reporting. Data relationships, yes, we have joins, we have relationships into the Power BI inbuilt. We can work with the joins also in a future classes. So this is about today. So once again, I'm trying to say, so please send your details like a contact details and reach out to Swapna immediately. So please do a message or you joined a class or something update. You'll receive a new link for tomorrow's class. Otherwise you will not receive. So maybe you'll miss the new class link for tomorrow. So please send the details. She will forward and update you accordingly. Okay. Any questions?
How many days is the to-do course?
So this is to-do course is a 1 month course. Okay, we'll go with a everyday 1 hour class. Completely development part, we'll teach end-to-end development process into Power BI side. After end of the course completion process, we'll give the data, like a project data, and we'll give the requirements to work with the requirements and hand out to me in a email.
So you will teach SQL also? Yeah, how it is? SQL and DAX.
DAX, yeah. DAX will follow commonly as a course content process. SQL, I'll teach in a separate class. People is required to that part. I'll teach in a two sessions if the people requirement has.
Because like a lot of trainers are not telling about SQL actually.
Yeah,
so that's the reason.
Process. But two sessions I'll give. See, SQL is a different course, but my student process, if any requests comes, I'll take a separate class to, I'll take another additional classes, teach SQL and data knowledge also.
Because like I have seen a lot of YouTube videos, like they are asking interviews also like in regards to SQL. So that's the reason.
No issue. See, SQL is a data communicative language. Okay. You are not going for a database developer, one thing. We are a reporting developers. But as a knowledge, as a interactive process, as a some beginning style level, I'll help you with the SQL teaching also as a free of cost. Okay.
And DAX, DAX will be included with this Power BI transaction only, right?
Yes, as a
DAX.
course contents also you can see DAX will be there. So DAX is a topic into the Power BI. DAX is not entire a Power BI. Okay, DAX is a one interactive of calculating part. So those I already mentioned in a content also. Please look into that part. And it's a more related to 1 2 day session into the course order wise. That is the process. Yeah.
Is there any external certification that you get for Power BI like?
Yeah, those questions we can see tomorrow. Okay, we have dedicated course questions. I'll repeat it tomorrow. Okay,
Okay.
so we have general people ask many questions. Like I have prepared 30 questions around. So tomorrow we'll discuss those items. Okay, but as of I am expecting, of today's class, if you have any questions, please ask me. Or what are the questions you have in mind? That is the regular questions. I'll give you answers tomorrow.
Sir, even though Power BI is fully automated, but what are the basic things we need to be know, means to understand in a better way, Power BI.
So Power BI is a tool, it's not a language. One thing. So here I'll say one word. 1 hour to listen the class, 1 to 2 hours is to practice the class.
Okay.
Okay. If you begin the day like that, in a 30 to 40 days period, you'll completely strong into the Power BI. One thing I'm repeating, it's not a coding, it's not a language, it's a tool. Tool nothing but already have options. We just interact and you have to play with the tool. That's it. But the knowledge accept you. Knowledge is to understand a data side. The data side knowledge also I'll provide you in the same classes parallelly. So I'll teach a data classes also to understand the data side. Okay. So then you'll understand the data. Then also you'll understand Power BI both. Then you'll start.
Thank you.
Okay.
So, can we install this tool in our personal laptops, or do we need any license kind of thing to
Yeah, those
work?
things once our actual course will started from day after tomorrow. Okay,
Okay.
first day I'll guide the infrastructure installation process. I'll take a control. Okay, who are joined,
Okay.
everything I'll take control. Not to worry. Yeah, okay. Thank you. Please send your updated details into your contact details to Swapna. She will reach out to you. Don't miss, otherwise not get any new links for tomorrow and upcoming classes. So thanks for joining.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.